Greetings and welcome to our resting place. ASMR. How are you? How are you? How are you? It's so good to see you, or to be with you again today. So I had a request from a viewer asking if I could go back to the old school method of layering audio over the video, and so which I want to oblige, especially because today's walk was so windy. So the 3D binaural mics picked up a lot of gusts of wind. It was really blistering out there. So I thought this would be a great opportunity to oblige to the request. And of course, we're back on the coastline today. Some of you might recognize this coastline from the first ever companionship and conversation video I did. Although the weather was very different then as well. I'll make sure to link that as well. Yeah, everything is growing during this summer period. It's incredible to see. Colors. It's just perfect. I need to learn to slow down when I'm panning shots, I think, looking back at this in retrospect. I think it might be a bit too dizzying. It gives me the chance to insert some stuff that I might have missed out on before, and I think that's to mention how important my grandfather was in my youth and in helping me grow up to be the man that I am today, I think, and chiefly to show me these great spots for walks all over North Wales. Hello. It was thanks to him, really, that I know a lot of these places to take you. He taught me a lot about virtues and about stoicism and about following through on your word and my days. I think when he was my age he had like 6 children. I could never myself. But it was a different world back then, I guess. And there are a lot more options available these days in comparison, I guess, as to what people are looking for in their lives. Some people are just purely career-driven, some people are family-driven, and whatever your preference is, there's choice for everyone, really. And so, yeah, so the berries are coming in as well. They'll be ready to pick at the end of summer to make pies and cakes, etc. Do you have a particular favourite? Do you have a particular cake or pie that you enjoy? My grandfather used to make banana cake, which you take the slightly bruised and overripe bananas and then turn it into a cake, which was absolutely delicious. Taste and the smell still stays with me today. And so here we are back on the coastline. As you can see over there is the lighthouse, and we took some took a walk down there a few videos ago, down those steep steps together. I should probably try and link that in the video as well. Find it a little bit tricky trying to find walks sometimes where there's no one around, so I can just record without any interference, especially if I'm running a dialogue narrative conversation with you whilst I'm recording. Yeah, so this place is good for that. So we're approaching the coastline now. I haven't been down here since, well, this spot here since about 2010. Obviously I've filmed along the other areas on and off over the years, but this bit going down this hill, I haven't been here since that long ago. But I do remember having like a feast the last time I was at this bit. I think at that time we'd laid out like a bunch of summer foods from like Tesco or Morrison's or something like that. And it was perfect. There's no wind at all. It was completely calm. Man, great memories. The patterns in the sky is something else, huh? Or something. nose combined with stinging nettles are the worst. Isn't it? So, so lucky to be around it. I always found that when I was living in the cities, really missed the sea the most. Like, being by the coastline just represents that ability to have your freedom. Naive idea of, oh, I've had enough, I'm going to get in a boat and sail away or something, you know. Anyway, we've reached the coastline. There's various caves and whatnot further down there. My grandfather used to tell me that there were mines from World War II washed up. Whether there's any truth in it, I'm not sure, but I do remember him telling me about it. Over there in the distance, we can see one boat sailing, probably a westerly pageant or something like that. Gosh, it's massive, isn't it? The whole sky. I had low feelings last night, and I went outside for a moment and looked up, and the sky was super clear, and I could see all the stars, and it gave me perspective and sort of normalized everything again. It's amazing how the world can provide. Like, the world continues to provide for you. Whether you like it or not, it's always there for you. I remember in my teenage years, I was feeling quite isolated. And I was sitting on a bench. I went out and sat on a bench or something like that. Being super angsty or whatever. Birds started approaching, like seagulls and blackbirds and stuff, and then I think like 20 minutes later, like a stray dog started appearing. And it was kind of funny how I'd put this thought out into the universe, then these animals started appearing. It was a little bit like Ace Ventura, you know, when all the animals start flocking around him. I was like, oh, I'm not alone. There are other sentient beings around me. I don't know, random thought of the day, I guess. That's the first time I've thought about that, actually, in quite a while. See that the cows are sitting down, so that means that rain is coming. So I thought it was a good idea to bring the video to a close in the next minute. So I guess, oh yeah, there's the caves again. I guess all that's left to say is thank you so much for stopping by today. Obviously, more and more videos are coming, and more streaming is happening. I hope you have a good day. Thinking of you always, your friend, James. me. Bye-bye.